Viewers, big problems. Big problems for the Bharatiya Janata Party. Why? Just, viewers, a month before the elections in Uttar Pradesh, what do you have? You have one of its biggest OBC faces in government walking out. Yes, viewers, walking out. Swami Prasad Maurya, an OBC leader in government, walks out. Now, why is this man's exit so critical? Viewers, because the BJP banks on non-Yadav OBCs in Uttar Pradesh. It will weaken the BJP's position in eastern Uttar Pradesh, which is a crucial battleground already. The BJP has problems in western Uttar Pradesh. After Rajbhar, Maurya's exit dents the BJP's OBC vote bank and this big claim that it has with it the pichra classes or castes, as the BJP claims. He was a 5-time MLA in Uttar Pradesh, was labor minister in the Yogi government, MLA from Padrona in Kushinagar district, holds huge sway among non-Yadav OBCs, prominent backward caste leader of eastern Uttar Pradesh, considered a powerful Maurya community leader, was in BSP earlier, considered close aide of Mayawati. He has walked out. He has joined the Samajwadi Party. Three other MLAs are walking out. These are now a group of 11 who have left the BJP. As I told you, even Mr. Rajbhar has left the BJP. Important leaders. This is what Mr. Maurya had to say, saying that the BJP gives Dalits a raw deal. This is what he said. Listen in.
Kishano, Rozgar, Nojwano, Evam, Chote, Laghu, Madhyam, Vyapariyon, Ke Khilaaf, Lagatar, Kaam Karne Ka Prayas Kiya, Inke Hausle Ko Past Karne Ki Koshish Ki Gayi, एक जाति वर्ग विशेष के लोगों को बढ़ावा दिया गया, दलित और पिछड़े अधिकारियों को विरोधी की टोकरी में डाल दिया गया और उत्तर प्रदेश की जनता की अनदेखी की गई। कई बार उचित प्लेटफॉर्म पर मैंने अपनी बातें भी रखी, लेकिन भारतीय जनता पार्टी के नेता हवा में उड़ रहे थे। इनको बहुत बड़ा घमंड था और इसलिए अभी तक मैं मंत्रिमंडल में मंत्री होने के नाते मंत्रिमंडलीय सामूहिक जिम्मेदारी का निर्वहन कर रहा था। जैसे ही सूचना असूचना जारी हुई, निर्वाचन आयोग ने चुनाव कराने की घोषणा किया। मैंने उत्तर प्रदेश को और इस सरकार के जुर्म, जाति अत्याचार, शोषण और गलत नीतियों से बचाने के लिए
Well, let me quickly go straight across to Sanju Verma. Sanju Verma, you know, before an election, it is said that people desert a sinking ship. The Samajwadi Party says BJP is sinking. You lost the Kisan because of the farm laws, allegedly. Now, the EBCs are upset with you. These are important constituencies. And they say it's because of your bias. How do you respond?
Rahul, you know, I will borrow the phrase that I saw you using yesterday while showcasing the Times Now poll. You told the Congress that if the Congress wins Uttar Pradesh, you're willing to eat your shoes mixed with salt and pepper. And I'll tell you this, if the BJP does not win Uttar Pradesh, I'm willing to eat my sandals with a whole lot of salt, pepper and red chilies, what have you. I do agree that Swami Prasad Maurya was a 5-time MLA from Padrona. So the fact that he's a heavyweight is something that I will not dismiss. That would be being very cavalier about having lost who was the Minister for Labour, which is an important portfolio. But don't forget that his daughter, Sangharitra Maurya, continues to be a BJP MP from Badaon. And don't forget that apart from the Mauryas, the BJP has a very strong bastion within the other non-Yadav OBC category, be it the Sainis, be it the Koeris, be it the Kurmis. In fact, I want to highlight that Kurmis account for more than 15% of the OBC vote bank at this point. and are actually even more relevant from a speech and vote share perspective than the Yadav, which is something that the media is not discussing.
Why is he quitting? Simple question, madam. Why is he quitting? Either you ill-treated him or he doesn't think you have prospects.
No, Rahul, so I will say this to you, and I will repeat what JP Nadda has said on umpteen occasions and on your channel as well. BJP is a party which has a huge cadre base, is very deep and very broad hierarchy and organizational strength. BJP is not a one-man or a two-man or a three-man show.
Okay. It's not a one-man, two-man or a three-man show.
Are you dismissing Keshav Prasad?
People come and go. I'll ask Vivek Salas that. Are you dismissing Yogi Adityanath? You think by pulling away what one Rajya Sabha BJP MP has defined Mr. Maurya as trash, by winning trash over to your side, you're going to win Samajwadi Party? Please respond, sir. This is what Sanju Verma is trying to say. Don't dismiss Yogi.
Yes,
are you
very
dismissing Yogi? Yes. So why? Mr. Silas. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Actually, I'll definitely agree to you, Rahul ji. Very good evening to you. The Bharatiya Janata Party is a sinking ship in Uttar Pradesh. There is no doubt about it. That is why people are leaving the party. The big shots are leaving the party. And I'll tell you why. If you see what happened today, all the other, one was the cabinet minister, Mr. Swami Prasad Maurya. If you see the other, Sanju Verma talked about Kurmis. The two MLAs, the three MLAs that have left the Bharatiya Janata Party today, two of them are Kurmis themselves. And people are so fed up of the Bharatiya Janata Party that they are ready to join the Samajwadi Party unconditionally. And let me tell you one more thing, very humbly.
You have lost
there will be many such jolts in the time.
Let him finish, please. Yeah.
I would just like to tell you very humbly, Rahulji, that there are many, many jolts like this which are going to come in a very short period of time. We'll discuss it every day. So that is the thing. People are fed up of the Bharatiya Janata Party. You talked about
very quickly, viewers. Look at your screens. One of those MLAs who is supposed to have gone along with Mr. Maurya today. 1 minute, please. Some breaking news coming in. One of those MLAs that is supposed to have gone along with Mr. Maurya today, his daughter has come out and made a stunning claim. She has said that he has been tricked. He has been forced to switch sides. This is yet another clangor, viewers. Breaking here, we'll play out that soundbite. Let's play out the soundbite, Nizam bhai. Let's bring it to our viewers' attention.
विधायक विधुना श्री विनय शाह की पुत्री रिया शाह की हूँ। मेरे पिताजी को 1 मई 2018 को ब्रेन स्ट्रोक पड़ा था, जिसके बाद उन्हें लखनऊ के पीजीआई अस्पताल में भर्ती कराया गया था। मैं धन्यवाद देना चाहती हूँ हमारे यशस्वी मुख्यमंत्री योगी आदित्यनाथ जी का कि उन्होंने उच्च स्तर पे डॉक्टर पैनल टीम बनाकर मेरे पिताजी का इलाज करवाया और स्वयं मेरे पिताजी को 4 से 5 बार पीजीआई अस्पताल में देखने आए। मेरे पिताजी ना तो स्पष्ट तरीके से बातचीत कर सकते हैं और ऑपरेशन होने के बाद उनके सोचने समझने की शक्ति भी कम हो गई है। हम लोग क्षेत्र में भारतीय जनता पार्टी के लिए काम कर रहे हैं क्योंकि
Well, there you heard it, viewers. Vinay Shakya's daughter has come out and said that there is something quite strange. My father has suffered a stroke, not in his senses. Sensational twist, viewers, at prime time on this story. Where does it lead? We'll be looking deeper into this, viewers. We'll take a very short break. We are back with the top stories and the News Hour special edition. Don't go away.